Welcome back to PSK Nadasiravi YouTube channel. We continue with the basics of Kotlin programming language. We already discussed about the basics of Kotlin programming language. In this video, we are going to discuss about the control flow structures or control flow statements of Kotlin language. There are five types of control flow statements or expressions in Kotlin, which are some of them are similar to Java or other programming languages, and some are rare and new to programming language. The syntaxes are about already same comparing to others, but a small changes. Some small changes are there. First is the if expression. The control flow structure is the if expression. In most programming languages, we use if statements as well as if expression. But in Kotlin language, we use if expression. That means we do not use the ternary operator, because the if statement can be used as an expression that returns a value. Therefore, that's why there is no ternary operator in Kotlin. So, the traditional usage is given in the screen. We can identify that there are a lot of statements in this usage. But if we rewrite this section of code into Kotlin expression, then we can write it as a single line code. Okay. And if branches can be block, and the last expression is the value of a block. That means we can write the if statement and expression as well as statement by using curly braces. But one thing we notice that, not that, the last statement is the return value or the value of that block. The example is given in the screen. And the second expression is when expression. When expression is similar to the switch case in C language, or switch case in any other language. Here, it can be used as an expression rather than using it as statement. We can use the when expression as an expression. The syntax is given in the screen. Then we can combine the condition using commas. This is a more light version of switch and look like look like the switch case. Okay. Then the loops. Loops are three types. The first is for loop. The for loop in Kotlin is somewhat equivalent to for each loop in the other language like C sharp or Python, etc. Okay. It have the syntax for bracket for function, then inside that item is the iterated keyword, and then the in keyword, then the collection variable. Then we can proceed by writing the statement. If it is a single statement, it can be written in the single line, or we can use a block of statements by using or enclosing it in the curly braces. And the next is the while loop. While loop and do while loop are exactly the same in the Java. Comparing the Java, the Kotlin language have the same syntax and same purpose here. And we can use the range in the for loop. Range. To iterate over a range of numbers, we can use range. That is, a range operator is in Kotlin. That is, two dots. If I am writing for I in 1.3, print I, and it means that I is the iterator variable, and in i.3 means it is a range, so that I should be should check that 1 to 3 the values will be I equal to 1, I equal to 2, I equal to 3. That is the range in for loop. If we have a program called like for I in 6 down to 0 step 2, print I. Then it means that down to is when we if we want the numbers in decreasing order, that is first 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, etc. But here in this, this example, the step is 2, 2. That is first is 6, then 6 minus 2. That here we use the down to keyword. The step is set to 2, but the keyword is specified as down to, then it means that 6 minus 2, the next number is 4, then 2, and next is 0. Up to down to 0, 0 y. And if we want to iterate the array or a list with index, we can use the indices property of the array. Example, for I in array name dot indices, print array of I or array name of I. Then we can get the array element in that ith position. We can also use the with index function. In this time, instead of the iterated variable, single variable, we specify a key value pair. That means index and value pair. An example is given. That means for index comma value in array dot with index function, print element. So the print string templates can be applied here using the index and value. Okay. We discussed shortly about the control flow structures in Kotlin. They are if expression, when expression, for loop, while loop, do while loop, and the final the range in for loop. Okay. Hope the viewers may like this video. If you like this, then please subscribe and like this video. If you want to share, or if this is a new knowledge to you, then share to everyone. Okay. Thank you for watching.